Let us see a problem on pole zero representation. The problem for today is y of n minus y of n minus 1 plus 3 by 16 y of n minus 2 equals to x of n minus 1 by 2 x of n minus 1. Now, this is a similar kind of equation we have seen. This is a difference equation with set of y's and set of x. Now here we have seen that the difference equation have summation which goes from 0 to n. Here the n range is 2 and here the m range is 1. So here n is equal to 2 and m is equal to 1. Okay. So to solve this problem, we apply step 1, apply z transform. So when we apply z transform, all y of n's will get converted to y of z because of linearity property, plus and minus will be kept as it is. Then n minus 1 we have to multiply by z inverse, and then again y of z plus 3 by 16, this is my constant value, n minus 2, I will have z raised to minus 2, and then again y of z. This is equal to, your x of n will go to x of z minus constant y of 2 z inverse x of z. This is my first step. We have applied z transform to the problem. Now step 2, taking common y of z and x of z. So we have y of z into 1 minus z inverse plus 3 by 16 z raised to minus 2 equals to x of z into 1 minus 1 by 2 z inverse. Therefore, y of z upon x of z, which is my transfer function h of z, is equal to, I will keep this as the numerator and bring down this as a denominator. So now we have seen that I got my system transfer function with the numerator polynomial having 1 minus 1 by 2 z inverse and the denominator polynomial having 1 minus z inverse plus 3 by 16 z raised to minus 2. Now, to apply our mathematics, we will convert all z inverse to z raised to plus degrees. It is all negative powers, we will convert to positive powers. So, I will multiply and divide by z square to the numerator and denominator. So, I will multiply z square over here, I will get 1 minus 1 by 2 z inverse divided by z square over here, and I get 1 minus z inverse plus 3 by 16 z raised to minus 2. So, I have multiplied numerator and denominator by z inverses, z square. Then, taking them inside will give me z square minus 1 by 2 z divided by z square minus z plus 3 by 16. Okay, so now this is a process, or this is an equation which is handled using normal mathematics. In the numerator, what I can do is I can still write it like this, z into z minus 1 by 2, and the denominator I'll write z square minus z plus 3 by 16, which is h of z. Now, the denominator will have two roots because it is z square. Okay, so we need to determine this two roots of an equation with the degree 2, that is z into z minus 1 by 2 divided by z minus 1 by 4 and z minus 3 by 4. So the two roots of this equation comes as z minus 1 by 4 and z minus 3 by 4. Now we have our h of z as final h of z as z to z minus 1 by 2 divided by z minus 1 by 4 into z minus 3 by 4. So, the poles of the equations are P1, which is equal to 1 by 4, and P2, which is equal to 3 by 4. Whereas, the zeros of the equation is z equals to 0 and z equals to 1 by 2. So, if you put z is equal to 0 in this case, again this will hold go to 0 and the numerator will come to 0 and the h of z will go to 0. So, this is a 0 at z is equal to 0. This is at z is equal to plus 1 by 2. Now, to represent this, I will go to my z plane where I have a circle with radius r equals to 1. Now, 1 by 4 will be less than 1. It is a pole with real value. So, my real axis of z is the x axis and this is my imaginary z axis. There is no imaginary term. There is all real terms. So, I will have a real pole at plus z 1 by 4 and 1 will be 3 by 4. So, I will have two poles like this. Okay. So, let us say P1 and P2. Okay. And I will have a 0 at origin and a 0 somewhere around here. This is, let's say, Z1. This is Z2. So, this is my pole 0 representation of a given transfer function or a given difference equation. Thank you.